number of people had created, had gathered momentum, and they have carried that momentum because nobody is stopping them. For us, it is just serious crime. And that's why we said one of the ways we are going to do that is to create what we call the serious crime squad, you know, and properly train these people. We know that sentiments and emotions actually guide or determine some of the activities of Mr. President. And in the last few months, there was supposed to be a collaboration between the United States Army and the Nigerian Army. All of a sudden, because of certain disagreements on the side that has nothing to do with security, Nigeria called that off.
Okay, General Buhari said...
How do you know this?
Oh, it's in the public place. It was announced. In fact,
certain disagreements that have nothing to do with security.
That has nothing to You're do with sure security. You're sure of that? I am. That has nothing to do with security.
You're very sure that...
Of course.
Let me ask a question here before we ask a question. Does your party love this country? Does your party love this country?
Oh, come on, it's obvious. Yes, we do.
Okay. And that is why we have more than...
If your party loves this country...
We have 70 million very poor people. Okay. It has just been reported now that Nigeria leads four other countries in Nigeria, in Africa, in the African continent, as the poorest.
If your party loves our country...
And you have that kind of statistics, and you are comfortable, and you are actually telling me to come back.
Can I ask a question? Your party loves this country.
Yeah.
How much effort did you make towards contributing towards, ending insurgency?
Ending the insurgency?
Yes.
That question...
Or maybe I should just add to it. Hmm. Does APC need to take over power before, you know, contributing to making sure that insurgency ends in Nigeria?
You must look at it globally. When there is insurgency, it is about engagement, it's about military engagement. And when you have military engagement, the only structure in terms of hierarchy that talks to security is the commander-in-chief. See, when you force people to come and negotiate, when you talk to people, to a crowd of people that is leading an insurgency, you can only talk to them when you are running them down. That is the basic philosophy of negotiation. You must always negotiate from the point of strength. If you don't, Boko Haram is taking my territory by the day. Boko Haram is emboldened because even when they appear in towns where you have military barracks, it is reported that our soldiers start to run.
Let's hear from Mr. Owo. Mr. Owo, he said the only person that can talk to the military is the commander-in-chief. But the commander-in-chief also has a council of state, of which your candidate is a member of. So how does that work? And the council of state is supposed to advise the commander-in-chief.
Yes. Does he take advice? Was he giving advice?
That's the first.
That's the question you should ask.
He was.
Let him land then.
I'm on the floor, so you just give me some small minutes, you know?
Go ahead, please.
Does he take advice? If I advise you on certain things you must do that will better us and you don't take it, I take care of myself.
So are you saying he was advised in this instance?
Of course, yes.
How can you prove this?
Take for instance. Before now, even the Northern elders were so disappointed with the issue of Boko Haram at some point. And they called Mr. President severally and even used General Muhammadu Buhari as the chairman of, how do I call it? That's the chairman to bring the insurgents and the presidency together to negotiate.
Okay. The mediation team.
Okay. He accepted it. But when he rolled out his plans and the president could not see his plans, he didn't want to go on anymore. And so there was a proper advice as well at that level, which the president did not agree. Come again. When they say that SAS, Mondo Sheriff of Borno State, was involved in the issue of Boko Haram, how did the presidency handle it? The presidency rather protected the man who was said to be involved in the issue of Boko Haram. And so when you see the man who is commanding the force, and of course the military is killed, and they're just sitting there quiet, giving Nigerians hope that the issue will be solved, And the issue is not solved. What do you do?
But the PDP members won't agree with you that the president is just sitting quietly.
They will not agree. No, but these are obvious facts. We are stating them obvious.
No,
it's true.
Okay, let me ask Mr. Ohazurike. Yeah. The General Buhari has said he's going to do to end insecurity if elected. What does this mean to you?
Yeah, but the problem I have with the alternative party and the way they present their issues. They just come and make pronouncements. They don't substantiate how that the how is a question. When you ask 2-3 APC members how, you will get 2-3 different answers that cannot coexist.
I am giving you enough hours.
The man privatized power. I expected them to attack that, to say he shouldn't have. They did not. He had a power roadmap. I expected them to say, roadmap.
The question
look
I
at
asked
this,
is about security. What you think of General Muhammadu Buhari saying he's going to end insecurity.
If you want to campaign for president today, the first thing you can tell a Nigerian and get the sentiments on your side is, I'll end Boko Haram. If General Buhari said, I'll end Boko Haram, and he didn't say, look at how I'm going to do it.
That's a question.
Do you think it is possible that a General Buhari must have advised, sorry, I'm calling him General Buhari. I don't usually call him General Buhari. I call him Mr. Buhari for obvious reasons, which I'll state very soon. Now, for Mr. Buhari to say that he will end Boko Haram, he should have said, I advised the sitting president to do A, B, C, D, which I think are the solutions to this problem, and he has not done it, probably because I had a military training and he didn't have, so he may not have seen it from my view, but that is how I'm going to do it if I am president. It will make meaning to you and I. But who won't come out and say, I'll end hunger, I will eradicate poverty? These are the sentiments you want to get from the ordinary man. But Mr. Buhari should have said, I want to end Boko Haram. Look at how I'm going to do it. I'll do A, B, C, D. Coming to say from a position of strength, that means you attack and then you start negotiating. These are just generalized statements. There are no specifics there. I said I call him Mr. Buhari for a fact, for a reason, but it's clear.
You'll be going away from the security issue.
No. I'm circulating around it and I'm going to hit the nail on the head now. Because the man has not done what the law required him to do. The law says list 4 issues for you to be qualified to be president. He has not met those 4 points by the Constitution. He has not shown the world in general, and Nigerians in particular, that he is qualified to be a candidate as stipulated by the Constitution.
Please make it short.
For now, Mr. Buhari shouldn't be an issue in the equation of Nigerian presidency and who will be president. By the time he will come in is when he is qualified to come in. He has not shown the world that he has been trained up to school certificate level. He has not shown the world that. Until he does that, it is not the issue of INEC. You know, when you talk about issues in an election, you talk of power, you talk of security, you talk of economy, you talk of corruption, you talk of agriculture, every other issues, the personalities involved must form an issue, and they do really form an issue in discussions.
His personality doesn't have to do anything with affecting security. The views I have about life,
there are people who are pro-life. There are somebody who says, under any circumstance, don't abort a baby. There are people who say, unwanted pregnancy. That's your view. It will count if you are president.
Let's talk security.
On the issue of security. On the issue of security. I had expected them, when they addressed this issue of security, to have said, what General Buhari would have done. When this president said, give me $1 billion, I need to acquire specific hardware, military hardware,
the APC as a party came out openly to say, no, don't approve it. Thank God some of the members in the National Assembly saw beyond the sentiments of politics and went ahead to approve that. And the man has gone ahead to start acquiring more compliant military hardware, and that is what is being deployed. Mm. Some of them are still on the way. They are coming. Nigeria does not have the technical capacity or know how to indigenously develop some of these things, the helicopters that are needed and the other military hardware. Now, for now, to solve this insurgency problem, we need to import those things. But if APC loved this country like they professed here, they wouldn't have said no. What they should have said is set up mechanisms to ensure that this one billion
all right, thank will you. Be used. Azarike, you would respond, but as you're responding, we're winding down.
Okay, so
please go ahead and do your response.
Yes, and in your response, because all of these issues now that we've been talking about, I'm sure some people are at home getting a bit confused, because this will say this, that will say that. Every candidate is coming out to say, I would do this, I will do that. How do you think the electorate can discern that person that is foresighted, that person that is going to address the yearnings and the wishes of Nigerians?
It's and that's why we said we should just talk to issues. Talking about security, this year's 2014 national budget, 20% of our 4.7 trillion national budget is committed to security. 20%. Now, plus that, the president went seeking for $1 billion. That's confusing. All right, he secured the $1 billion. The next we had was a 9 point something million naira, yeah. I mean, million dollar being taken in a private jet to South Africa to secure arms. When you have a sitting Ministry of Defense, when you have a sitting Minister of Defense, and you know this is wrong, this is not how you do things. And we also had that the president was going to shop for military helicopters in a country that has nothing to do with military.
So for you, during this election period now, what is it that you will tell the Nigerian electorate to look out for when it comes to who to vote for?
Yeah, someone that will tackle corruption, that has 100% commitment to tackling corruption. Someone that will redeem our economy. Someone that will take care of the extreme poor that this government had generated for Nigeria.
Thank you.
So, please, you see,
straight to the point,
have,
please.
When you have a father, and you go to the father, to your father's house, and he tells you welcome all the time, you are in love with him. When you get to your father's house and you have committed a crime, and your father tells you, kneel down there before you even get close to me, it means he hates you. Nigeria know that General Buhari, even as a military president in this country, have ideas on how to manage security crisis and corruption. And that was why he had what we call war against indiscipline. And so every Nigerian know that if General Buhari becomes president, he will tackle the issue of corruption, he will tackle the issue of security. And so we want Nigerians to know this country is at the brink of collapse.
Thank you.
So it is General Buhari that can be the president.
Quickly, yeah, please. Quickly.
Very quickly. You cannot give what you don't have.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Well, thank you, gentlemen, for coming on the show. As I said, we're still expecting Taiwo Kuye of the PDP, Financial Secretary, PDP Lagos, who told us he was waiting for his driver to bring him to the studio, but he couldn't make it. Thank you, gentlemen, once again for coming. But we'll take a quick break and we'll come back to continue on another perspective. Please stay with us.